was missing a Keith Sweat feature. And I know y'all talking like, man, what the hell is Q talking about? What Keith Sweat got to do with the Jay-Z album? Well, him and Beyonce was going through it. So if you want to make it right with your, you know, with your significant other, you got to throw Keith Sweat in there.
This is Hip Hop Album Debate. Let's get the conversation going. Ain't no time to waste. Yeah, the podcast that I know you've been wanting. They talking real hip hop. Got everybody talking. Let's go. Yeah, keeping 100 and stay true. Hosted by my homie Q. Tune in and come through. Yeah, this be the spot. The number one place all day. This is Hip Hop Album Debate. Let's go. Hey, yeah.
Welcome to Hip Hop Album Debate, the podcast. This is your boy Q, and this is episode 26. All right, and this debate topic is Jay-Z's 444 album. All right, before we get into this debate, discussion, or whatever, all my YouTubers, anybody that's on YouTube, man, y'all be sure to like, subscribe, hit the bell button, all that fun stuff, and like all the social sites, man. I'm on Instagram, Hip Hop Album Debate, Twitter, HH Album Debate, and Facebook, Hip Hop Album Debate. So yeah, y'all be sure to like your boy across all the platforms, all right? But yeah, today's debate topic is 444 album, Jay-Z. Is it a classic? Is it dope? Is it regular? Or is it garbage? And, well, when Jay-Z first dropped this album, which was back in 2017, well, you know what? First and foremost, it's been 5 years. So what's up? Y'all think it's time to talk about it? Is it too early to talk about it? I think when you're dealing with an album and we're discussing if it's a classic or not, I think, I don't know, man. It's kind of like some people believe in love at first sight. You know, some people don't. And I don't know, man. I think a classic album, I think that's kind of like love at first sight. If you believe in it, and me personally, I don't think I do, man. So I think it's kind of hard to tell if it's a classic right away. I mean, I think you would know if it's dope or not, but I think it's just hard to say if it's a classic. You know what I'm saying? So, but this album been out for 5 years now, so I think we could talk about it now. You know what I'm saying? I think we can discuss it. And you know, Jay-Z, he was dropping some gems on this album. You know, he criticized the people, you know, just holding the money up, you know, the money phone, you know, what them young cats was doing. And, you know, hey, what's better than throwing money at a strip club? Hey, Jigga told us it's credit. So, you know, he giving us some game on this album. But, one of my gripes with this album when I first heard it, and it wasn't many gripes, I mean, I thought this was a dope album the first time I heard it. Like, I'm like, okay, this is a banger. But I wish Jay-Z would have came with this type of album a little sooner than what he did. Because he been in the game for a minute. And, you know, Jay-Z was talking his flashy talk, you know, for a lot of his albums. You know, he did this and that. In the drug game, and nobody's, you know, doing it bigger than him. That's kind of been his persona. And so, okay, he hit us with this 444. Okay, now he giving us game. But to me, I'm like, well, damn, Jay-Z, he should have given us this type of album, man, at least 10 years sooner. You know what I'm saying? I mean, you look at the Black Album, that should have been his retiring album. I mean, he said that was his last album. And he really didn't give us no game. You know, he didn't really give us no knowledge, no wisdom. You know what I'm saying? He was just, your, you know, hey, change clothes and go. You know, so 444, hey, We got it when we got it. Hey, as the old saying goes, better late than never. So I was happy that Jay-Z did, you know, step up and play the OG role and really give us some game through this album. He was real on his boss talk, you know, like his smile. He says, fuck a slice of the apple pie, I want my own cake. And he also says, you know, it was fuck you pay me, now it's fuck paying me, I pay you. So that's the ultra, you know, boss talk. I mean, I guess he giving this game and he's still, you know, he's still, I guess you flip the other side of the coin, it's still Jay-Z. You know, so I guess it's OG on one side of the coin, and then the other side, you know, he's still jigger. But either way it goes, man, it was a dope album. It was an honest album. Him and Beyonce was going through it, you know, that I think it became public knowledge, and he acknowledged it, you know, on the Family Feud album, song. And, you know, I mean, it was a dope album. It was an honest album. I think the only thing it was missing a Keith Sweat feature. And I know y'all talking like, man, what the hell is Q talking about? What Keith Sweat got to do with his Jay-Z album? Well, him and Beyonce was going through it. So if you want to make it right with your significant other, you got to throw Keith Sweat in there. And it would have been nice to get, you know, Keith Sweat doing what he does on the hook or something. Why not? But real talk. That this is not a joke. I would have loved to have Keith Sweat. You know, I would never do anything to hurt you. And have Jigga rapping on that. I thought that would have been cool and out the box. But anyway, what's my thoughts on this album? I think 444 was a dope album. I can't say it was a classic, but it was dope. And maybe I need to sit on it a little longer. Maybe when I come back to it in 5 years, it'll be 10 years old. And maybe I'll say, you know what? It is a classic. But, I can't say that right now. I just can't. No one spoke on this album. No one left a message through the speak pipe. No one commented. So that's unfortunate, because I would love to have heard you guys' opinion on this album. So, but it's okay though. We'll catch it on the flip side. But yeah, me personally, I thought it was a dope album. You know, that's just me. 444. But either way it goes, kudos to Jay-Z. I thought it was good to kind of bring this album up, because he was getting a lot of praise for his verse on DJ Khaled's God Did. And to me, I felt like 444 was kind of on the caliber of that verse. You know what I'm saying? So I thought it would be a good time to talk about this album. But y'all let your boy know something. Again, this is an ongoing conversation. You can drop a comment at any time. The speak pipe is no longer available, because once I close the polls, I make speak pipe unavailable, so you can't leave a comment, voice comment, but you can definitely leave a comment on the website, social media, and let's chop it up, man. So again, this is an ongoing conversation. Y'all let your boy know something. So I'm out for now. This is Q, Hip Hop Album Debate, the podcast. I'm gone. Peace. Hey.